So hey guys, this is another video tutorial of Windows System Programming. In this video tutorial, we are going to see how to synchronize the thread using counting semaphore and mutex. So we know there are mainly three use cases of semaphore. First one is the mutual exclusion or mutex lock. For this, you can check tutorial number 37 for the binary semaphore. Countdown semaphore, just like our counting semaphore, tutorial number 39. And notification you can check tutorial number 38 for deciding order of execution. So there are three use cases of the semaphore. If you see the difference between the semaphore and mutex, so semaphore is a signaling mechanism while mutex is locking mechanism. Semaphore is used for the process synchronization and thread synchronization, while mutex is for thread synchronization. Binary semaphore can act as a mutex, but mutex cannot act as a binary semaphore because semaphore does not provide ownership, but mutex provides the ownership. That is the fundamental difference between the binary semaphore and the mutex. So if you see in counting semaphore, if s becomes 2, means I'm initializing the semaphore with the value 2, then two thread comes simultaneously into the critical section, but order may not be same. Means suppose s becomes 1, then thread 1 will come, and while executing, thread 2 will come out from the critical section, then thread 1 will come. But in case of mutex, those who acquire the lock only can release the lock. So at a time only one thread can come into the critical section. So here are the Windows API. First one I'll use in this video tutorial is the create semaphore, create thread, wait for single object, release semaphore, create mutex, release mutex, and close handle. So create thread, you can check tutorial number 10, and create mutex, you can check tutorial number 12, and tutorial number 37 for the binary semaphore, how it works, and counting semaphore, tutorial number 39. So if you see the API, create semaphore, it took the four arguments. First argument is the security attribute, then initial count means initialization of semaphore, maximum count, and then name of the semaphore. Release semaphore, if you see, it takes three argument, handle of the semaphore, release count, then the previous count. Create mutex. Create mutex takes three argument. First one is the security attribute, so I'll put it here null. Then initial owner. If you see here, the initial owner, if this parameter is true, then caller created the mutex, the calling thread obtained ownership of the mutex object. What about if I put it here false? Then we have to use the wait for single object API for the ownership. And then third argument is the mutex name. And here they have already specified here. Do not forget to read this remark section. And release semaphore, it takes the handle of the mutex. Create thread. Six argument. First one is the security attribute, default stack size, so I'll put it here null. Thread startup function, thread parameter, creation flag, and thread ID. Wait for single object. Function return when the specified object is the signal state or when the timeout interval elapsed. Text two argument, handle of the semaphore or handle of the mutex. Then wait for the millisecond. Close handle, if you see here, close handle, it takes the only one argument, handle of the object, whether it is a semaphore or the mutex. So here I have already taken the handle of the semaphore. So in main function, I have taken the two handle for the thread one and thread two. Then step one, I have already created the here the counting semaphore, because I'm initialized the value of the initial count is 2 and maximum count is 2. So after that, I'm checking the condition of the semaphore. Now what I have to do, I have to create the mutex. So I'll use the global handle for that. Then h mutex. Then here use the API create mutex. First argument is the security attribute, so I'll put it here null. That means secure. Second argument is the initial ownership, so I'll put it here false. because I'm taking the ownership from the wait for single object API. So ownership, and then third argument is the mutex name. So I'm not providing any name here, so I'll put it here by default null. So mutex name, and then close this function. So what I have to do here, that's it. Now after that I'm checking the condition. Now I'm creating the two thread here. So argument is security attribute, then stack size, then thread startup function, then thread parameter creation flag and thread ID. Now after that I'm waiting for single object for all threads here. So I'm closing the handle for the thread, and step 6 is close handle for the mutex. So here I'm writing close handle. Now hmutex we have to write here, mutex object. Then I'm closing the handle for the semaphore. After that what we have to do here, we have to come into the this thread function. Name is mySync function. So I'm initializing one variable int I equal to 0. So basically I want to print 1 to 20. So while I less than equal to 20, so what will happen here? I'll use the wait for single object. First we have to provide the handle for the semaphore. So h semaphore. Now time is by default infinite, I'll put it. Then here we have to write release semaphore. First argument is the handle for the semaphore. So h semaphore. Release count 1, and now previous count I'll put it here 0. Now here we have to write one statement cout, and write here count, then plus I, and then end of this line. So what will happen? I'm not using any here for this time being. I'm not using any locking mechanism. I'm directly using the counting semaphore. So what will happen in that case? So let's see. Build succeeded, and see the here the synchronization is not proper. So what we have to do here? I'm using wait for single object and put it here handle for the mutex here. Mutex, and then time is same thing infinite. Mutex log. Now after that we have to write here release mutex. It takes the handle for the mutex, h mutex, and then closing. So here I am writing mutex unlock. So just try to run this program. So build succeeded, and now start running. If you see here, the synchronization is proper. Count 1. So what we have to do here, just change these things. I plus plus right here. So here to 20. Now put it here some delay 2 seconds and check. Build succeeded, and just see. So it will print From 0 to 19. That's it. So this was the basic program of how to use the counting semaphore and mutex for the thread synchronization. So hope you like this video. Thanks for watching this video. Do hit comment, share, and subscribe this channel.